Dear children, welcome back to the online class of Sri Gokulam Public School. Today, let's pass on to next important topic, namely changes in demand. When we talk about changes in demand, there are two type of changes. Number one, expansion and contraction of demand or change in quantity demanded. Number two, shifts in demand or increase and decrease in demand. Okay, today let's study about first type of change in demand, namely expansion and contraction of demand or change in quantity demanded. Okay, you know, demand is a function of its determinants. So many factors are there influencing demand for a good in a market. How demand is changing? Yes, you know, when these factors are changing, demand also has been changing. Let's study about the first type of change in demand, that is expansion and contraction of demand or change in quantity demanded. Here, what we are studying, expansion and contraction of demand are technical words, you know, used to denote change in demand due to change in price, assuming that other factors are held constant. Here, what we are studying, demand is a function of the on price alone, assuming that other factors are held constant. Okay? Once again, I am telling, expansion and contraction of demand are the technical words used to denote change in demand due to change in price, assuming that other factors are held constant. This is also known as change in quantity demanded. Okay, here what we are studying, demand is a function of the on price alone, assuming that other factors are held constant. Other factors like income, taste preferences, quality, etc. Okay? So, what do you mean by expansion? And what do you mean by contraction? We are analyzing how demand is changing when the own price is changing. Okay? But we are studying how demand is changing, how quantity demanded has been changing when the own price is changing, assuming that other factors are held constant. That is why this is also known as change in quantity demanded. What is it? Quantity demanded has been changing when the own prices are changing. So, expansion and contraction. Let's talk more about it. As you know, demand expands with a fall in price. Demand contracts with a rise in price. Demand expands, you know, with a fall in price. Demand contracts, you know, with a rise in price. Okay? Expansion and contraction means demand expands at a lower price and demand contracts at a higher price. So, how can we show expansion and contraction or change in quantity demanded through a diagram, through a demand curve? Demand curve DD, as you know, OX axis quantity, demanded Q1, Q2, Q3, etc. Over y axis price P1, P2, P3, etc. Okay? So, this is a demand curve DD. You can see various points on the demand curve A, B, C, etc. The corresponding price quantity combinations. At point A, P3 price, Q1 quantity. At point B, P2 price, Q2 quantity. At point C, P1 price, Q3 quantity. So, by moving along the curve, you know, by movement along the curve, you can show expansion and contraction. Quantity demanded has been changing when the own price is changing. Okay, assuming that other factors are held constant. By moving along a demand curve, you know, understand the meaning of movement along the curve. Point A to point B, point C. I can move from A to B and B to C. That's the meaning of movement along the curve. I can move from A to B, B to C. Movement along the curve. By moving along the curve, you know, we can show expansion and contraction. What causes movement along the curve? Price changes, you know. Okay. What causes movement along the curve? Price changes. Okay. We can show upward movements and downward movements along the curve. For example, movement from B to A, upward movement. Movement from B to C, downward movement. Upward movement B to A. You see the price. Price increases from P2 to P3. Downward movement from B to C. Price decreased from P2 to P1. Isn't it? So, movement from B to A, B to A, upward movement shows contraction. Movement from B to C, downward movement shows expansion. Right? So, what causes movement along the curve? Price changes. Okay? Upward movements are there, downward movements are there along the curve, you know. B to A, upward movement shows contraction. At point B, demand is OQ2. At point A, demand is only Q1. That shows contraction. Movement from B to C, downward movement, shows expansion. B, demand is only OQ2. You know, at point C, demand is OQ3. What's the meaning? Expansion and contraction means what? Demand expands at a lower price. Demand contracts at a higher price. Okay? When the own price is changing, quantity demanded has been changing. What causes a movement along the curve? Price changes. Price here P1, P2, P3. Quantity Q1, Q2, Q3. We can show upward movements and downward movements. Upward movements from B to A shows contraction. Downward movement from B to C shows expansion. So, you can see that demand expands, you know. Demand expands, you know. That is, demand increased, demand expanded, you know. Demand expands at a lower price. Demand contracts at a higher price. Isn't it? At a higher price, you know, demand contracts. At a lower price, you know, demand expands. Isn't it? Demand expands, you know, at a lower price. Demand contracts at a higher price. By moving along the curve, you know, we can show expansion and contraction. What causes a movement along the curve? Price changes. Upward movement shows contraction of demand. Downward movement shows expansion of demand due to price changes or price variations. Okay? So, when we talk about change in demand, first type of change is expansion and contraction. We analyzed how quantity demanded has been changing when the own price is changing. This can be shown, you know, by moving along the curve. What causes movement along the curve? Price changes. Upward movements are there, downward movements are there along the curve. Upward movement shows contraction. Downward movement shows expansion. That is, demand expands, you know, at a lower price. Demand contracts at a higher price. Okay, this is technically known as expansion and contraction. By moving along the curve, we can show these changes. This is also known as change in quantity demanded. Here we analyze demand is a function of the own price alone, assuming that other factors are held constant. Okay? Thank you.